PATAFA President Philip Juico. Philip, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning, Karen. Good morning to all of you.
Okay.
To be honest, I'm very happy to be here.
Thank you so much. Okay, very quickly, just a few questions because we have time constraints for now, which we can continue tomorrow. Number one, will PATAFA be issuing a public apology to EJ?
Wait. We cannot just go straight to that question because okay. It assumes certain things. Number one, the reason why we are having EJ investigated and not harassed, as some people are saying, and we are having him investigated, not just like that, not without basis. Because on September 9, I talked to his coach, to Sergey Bubka, and they told me Petrov had not been paid since 2018. And Bubka affirmed it. I said, are you willing to complain about that and prepare a sworn statement? The both of you? They said yes. If there is a hearing, an investigation, are you willing to be summoned? Yes. And then Petrov asked, will I have to travel to Manila? I said, well, let's do it by Zoom if it comes to that. So that's number one. That is the first fact. Now, their statements, Petrov's statements arrived much earlier. It is with me. It is signed, and this is going to be what will be investigated. And Sergey Bubka's sworn statement affidavit is here, and that will be asked. That will be used, and the investigating committee, I suppose, will ask about that. Number two, the second fact is this. When he said that, when this gentleman said that, we investigated. We did our preliminary investigation. And we knew that Mr. Obiena had liquidated these amounts, the amounts that PSC and PATAFA gave for Petrov salary fees from 2018 down to 2021. And we had liquidation reports with signature of Petrov. So we said, may disconnect. Sinabi, hindi binayaran, sabi nitong report ng ating athlete, binayaran, mayroong liquidation. May disconnect. This has to be looked into. Okay, so we started asking. And then I reported this to the board of PATAFA. Hindi personal ito. This is part of good governance. Okay. This is part of accountability, transparency. A certain amount of money was entrusted to you, pinagkatiwala sa'yo. There is a board resolution coming from PSC stating, dito mo gagamitin yan, ha? Yung mga yan. Okay, so tinitingnan namin po, yun nga ang ginawa. Eh, sa kwento nitong dalawa at sa affidavit, eh mukhang hindi. Okay, so we sent him a letter asking him questions. Prior to that, because of probably some other leak, bigla na lang si Petrov, the coach, wrote an email and said, binayaran na ako, Mr. Obiena, noong 85,000 euro. That's about 5 million pesos. So our people will know that we're not talking about some pichi-pichi amount. Ano? 5 million, close to 5 million pesos. Binayaran na ako, November 4, November 5, November 9. Yung ibinayad na sa kanya, galing sa iba-ibang sources. Hindi galing sa yung binigay na pera ng yes. Galing sa iba-ibang sources. Okay? Merong dalawa galing sa Arab Bank in Dubai. Okay? Which was also used in an earlier transaction. Merong isa galing sa kanya, kay Mr. Obiena, sa isang bank sa Germany. N20, parang Gcash daw yun. Tapos, merong dalawa galing sa mother niya. Yung mother ni EJ, at that time, was an officer of PATAFA, auditor. So, yung sinasabi ni EJ na sana may point person doon sa PATAFA, ayun, yung nanay niya. Pero si EJ, lumaki yan sa PATAFA. Okay? Lumaki yan. Nandun yung father niya, coach. Alam nila kung ano ang practices ng gobyerno sa sports. Alam nila ang vision ng PATAFA. Alam nila ang ugali ko at ugali ng mga tao doon. Kailangan matino tayo dito. Sapagkat hindi natin pera ito. We are in a stewardship role. Pinagkatiwalaan tayo. So, masama ba magtanong? Eh kami ang mag-a-account dyan eh. Mabuti sana kung kayo. Okay? So, ganyan ang nangyari. Merong binayad at ang laging inuulit-ulit, binayaran na daw. Ang tanong, kailan? November 4, November 5, November 9, 2021. Eh bakit merong liquidation noon? Pinakikita binayaran 2018, 2019, 2020, 2021. Ano yung gusto namin malaman? Ano ang nangyari? Ngayon, sinabi, nakukuha daw ng Pricewaterhouse. Titignan, go ahead. Dali niyo yung Pricewaterhouse, mag-usap kayo ng PSC. Kasi doon sinabit yung liquidation. Ngayon, ako ang nagdala kay EJ sa Formia, Italy. Hindi nila mapapagkailan yung buong pamilya. Pumunta sila sa akin, kasama ko si Sergey Bubka sa Sofitel Hotel 2014. Dumating yung buong pamilya, kasama si EJ, nakakorto. Mahiyain pa talaga, ngiti lang. Sabi ko, Mr. Bubka, Sergey, ito, itong batang ito, UAAP champion. May kinabukasan ito. Lumulundag ito ngayon yata ng 5.3, 5.4. 2014 na. Pwede bang kunin mo?
Okay.
Sure, ito, kukunin daw niya. So sumulat ako, ginawang scholar. So in yes. other words, inaalagaan yan. Inaalagaan yan. At alam niya yung alaga namin sa kanya mas lalo na nung bago mag-Olympics, nung nagkakagulo sa pole.
Okay.
So yun lang ang sasagutin. Bakit? Yeah. Yeah. Bakit meron liquidation doon? But, yun lang ang pag-uusapan natin. Wala nang iba. Wala nang yung keso ganito. Let's limit the issues. Yun lang.
Oh, very good points. Now, Philip, I don't have enough time, but would you want to continue this interview tomorrow on Head Start so that you can expound? Because there are several points that I do want to ask you. Would you be willing?
Well, you know, I don't want to be exchanging. There is an ongoing investigation.
Okay.
That's why from the very beginning I said, disyente kaming tao, ayaw namin itong point. Yung mga taong ito, kinuha namin sa board. Ang board nag-approve na magkaroon ng investigation. Ayoko naman babuyin yung ginagawa ng investigation. Salita ako ng salita. That's why I'm just saying, I'm limiting myself.
These are the facts. Okay. Now, just two quick ones because we have Market Edge up next. Just two. Is EJ claims that his funding has been cut September, October, November. Is that true? And will you...
No, it's not. It's not. Unang-una, yan si EJ. Alam mo ang ginawa niyan. After the Olympics, hindi namin makontak yan. Sabi niya kasi nagmumuni-muni. Pinahahanap ko dahil matatapos na ang Agosto. Eh, ang funding niya is only up to August 31. Sabi ko, papasok na ang bagong season. Hanapin niyo. Tapos sabi ng mga magulang, kami nga mismo eh, hindi namin makontak. Parang naka-block off or whatever. Finally, nagkausap sila ng aming Secretary General at the time, si Terry Capistrano, nag-submit siya ng budget August 31. Simula ng season September 1. Ha? Tagal-tagal namin siyang hinahanap. Ngayon, alam mo naman ang proseso ngayon, matagal na dahil sa bureaucracy. Tumatagal pa because of COVID. Nagkaka-COVID doon sa PSC, hindi pumapasok ang tao. Eh bakit ka naman magsasabit ng August 31? Pag-aaralan pa natin.
So Philip, just quickly, my last question now, just quickly, because you don't want to expound on, there isn't it. But what do you think then, did EJ do with the money from 2018 to 2020? If he did not, 2021, if he did not pay his coach?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm just here to give facts. I don't know. Maybe you should have asked him. He had a long interview with you, Panina.
Yes, yes. Yeah. Well, he did. What he said was he did submit long liquidations. That's what he said. He couldn't even want the job of paymaster.
Look, yung liquidation, all athletes do that.
Okay.
Tayo, when we travel abroad on official business, we have so many meetings, we have so many, we are tired at the end of the day. Sabi ni EJ, wala siyang kasama doon sa...
Yes.
He has plenty of time to do the liquidation at binigyan siya ng template ng PATAFA at ng PSC, filling the blanks na lang. Yan lang ang gagawin mo. Ano ba naman yung ilalagay mo yung resibo? Sila nagsabi, walang Pilipino, hindi lumalabas. Oh, meron ka naman kung oras pala eh. Lahat tayo. Tinanggap mo itong responsibility na ito. Kasama yan. Being an athlete is being accountable. Now, sasabihin mo, we are supposed to serve the athlete? Yes, but you are supposed to follow rules and regulations in accordance with principles of good governance and other principles of honesty, integrity, and justice. Ganun lang yun.
Is there
This is a two-way, you know, Karen, yeah. This is a two-way street. Hindi pwedeng salo.
So is there still chance for reconciliation because EJ will be representing the country in Paris?
We don't know that. We don't know. There's an investigation ongoing. Because I cannot say anything. I cannot commit to anything. It depends on what our committee comes up with and what our board says. We are an autonomous body. We make our recommendations. Sasabihin now we are at the mercy of PATAFA. Oh my gosh, huwag naman. But yun naman, masyado namang hyperbole.
So you're saying there's a chance that he may not represent the country?
Well, he himself said he may retire. I don't know.
In the latest interview now, he said he's really looking at Paris and he wants this resolved.
Well, he said he might retire from Philippine athletics. He did not say that he will retire from athletics. He just said Philippine athletics. That means there are other, another implication is there are other organizations to represent.
All right. Well, on that note, Philip, Headstart is open to you tomorrow if you're willing.
Yeah, but what time?
8:00 in the morning, sir, so we can talk about sports in general and several issues. So just to let you know, so
just to clarify, huh? Yeah. Those are the two issues.
Yes.
Okay. Late payment, late accounting. What happened to the first liquidation from 2018, 2019, 2021? Tamaro natin.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. And tomorrow, if you're willing, the show is open for you so we can give you enough time. Well, sir, I need to go.
You inviting me? If you're inviting
me? I am. Definitely, I am. I'm inviting you. And sir, forgive me, but Market Edge is up next. I'm 3 minutes over time. My apologies to Michelle Ong. I'll see you tomorrow, sir.